Hello everyone, my name is Vikal Jain and in this video we are going to learn how to find out the multiple lookup values. Now here we have numbers, here we have product. Let me show you, some numbers are repeating. So I am putting a filter, just select your data and Control Shift L. Now I am going to search a number. Let's say 335. See, it is repeating three times. Now what we are going to do, we are going to find out all the three values by using a lookup. Now I'm going to remove the filter. Now as we know, VLOOKUP is able to identify the first value only. Let me show you. So I'm using VLOOKUP. Lookup value is here, comma, table array would be number and product, both columns. Select your data. Now lock, comma, column number 2, comma 0. Now see, it is identifying only first value. Let me just put the filter. Now I'm going to search the value 335. Here it is. So it is identifying the only first value. Now let me try XLOOKUP. So XLOOKUP is going to identify the first value or the last value, but it can't find the middle value. Let me show you. Lookup value is here, comma, lookup array would be number column. Select your data, F4, comma, return array is here. Now comma, comma, comma. Here we have search mode. Now if you want to search from first to last, means top to bottom, then you can enter 1, and if you want to search from bottom to top, then you can enter minus 1. So firstly I'm entering 1 from top to bottom, for top to bottom. Now see, it is again identifying the first value. Let me just put the filter. Now again I'm searching 335. See, it is identifying only the first value. What if I'm going to put the minus 1 here? Now it is going to identify the last value, not the middle value. Let me show you once again. So search. Now here it is. Now what we are going to do, we are going to identify all the values in one cell, like here. Now let's begin. For this, what we are going to do, we are going to use filter function. So filter is able to filter out the transactions based on this lookup value filter. Now array would be both columns. Now lock, comma, include, I'm going to search, select the number column, lock, equal, this number, enter. Now see, it has identified all the three values, but it has taken two columns because we have two columns here. Now what we are going to do, we are going to split these two columns and remove this single column and extract this single column. Then we are going to join all the three values in one cell. So for what we are going to do, we are going to use choose column function, and this function is new in Excel, Office 365. Choose column. So what is your array? Array means your data. So here is my data, comma. So I'm using column number 2 because I want to take only column number 2. I don't need my first column. So enter. Now see, it is taking only the second column. It has ignored the first column. Now I'm going to concatenate all the three values by using text join. So text join, I'm joining through comma. Do you want to ignore empty? True, comma. So what is your text? So text is whole function, and mistakenly the choose column function has removed. I need to re-enter this choose column. Now close the parentheses and enter, and see, It has identified all the three values. Let me just put the filter once again. See, it is identifying all the three values. So if your data is large and you want to identify the multiple lookup value, you can take the advantage of these three functions. Now let's drag and drop and see, it is identifying all the multiple lookup value. It has two values, it has only single. Now again, here we have two values and two values. So keep enjoying and keep learning.